सो हेलो गाइज एंड वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल गाइज। माई सेल्फ दिपेश सोनी, आई एम आ ATSMU MBBS थर्ड ईयर स्टूडेंट। सो गाइज, दिस इज अगेन अ वन मोर वीडियो इन विच वी आर डूइंग इंटरव्यू विद डॉक्टर अविनाश, हु रिसेंटली क्लियर्ड हिज MCA एग्जाम। सो गाइज, बाय दिस वीडियो यू विल गेट टू नो वट आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू FMG एग्जाम, MCA एग्जाम विच यू आर गोइंग टू गिव इन योर फ्यूचर। एंड ऑल्सो आई मेड वन मोर वीडियो बिफोर दिस, that was also an interview with Dr. Mohit Pal, and I got a very good response from that video. So I thought that I should make one more video related to this, and I should interview with a different student so that we will get to know the strategy of the different student. So like this, we will continue our this series of the FMG aspirants who cleared their MCA exam by good marks and also cleared their MCA exam in the first attempt. This video we are doing the interview with Dr. Avinash, who recently cleared his MCA exam with a good score. So let's start the interview. Hello Dr. Avinash to our channel, and please tell to our viewers first of all that how is your life going after clearing the MCA exam?
Hey Dipesh, how are you doing? I'm doing perfectly great, bro. Thank you. Life is perfectly going fine for me. I just pray that the pandemic goes over soon and then everything gets back to normal.
I am also doing very good, and I also think that this pandemic condition should go from our world so that the condition should come normal. So let's start from your introduction. So please give your introduction to our viewers so that they may get to know that in which college you studied, from where you passed out, and when you cleared your MCA exam.
All right. Hello everyone. This is Dr. Avinash. I currently stay in Bangalore. I graduated from Our Lady of Fatima University from the Philippines. I recently cleared my FMGE exam in this August attempt.
So thanks a lot for your introduction. And now I just want to ask you one thing, that please tell me, how did you think of your preparation? Means, how do you started your preparation? From where you started your preparation? Because as you know, there are many resources to study, like PrepLadder, like Mero, also Bhatia, etc. Many online apps are there. And also you know that many of the students used to go Delhi, Gautam Nagar. In my last video also I discussed about this. But again, we will discuss this the same thing, because as you know, this is the important thing which every student have to face while they are preparing for their exam. As after completing their MBBS, they have to come to India and they have to prepare well for the FMG exam. So Dr. Avinash, please let me know, and our viewers should also know, that what is your preparation method? How did you prepare? Did you went to Delhi, or you prepared by any other thing, like any online resources or any other thing you decided to study for? So please let viewers know.
Alright, so when it comes to FMGE, the first thing that runs through in every FMGE's mind is joining a coaching center. That's exactly what ran through my mind. So I flew to Delhi at the start of March. Then I was thinking on joining coaching center, but after a few days when my friends joined, and then I was seeing their lifestyle, like starting off, their coaching center started off like 8 a.m. in the morning and ran like until 7 in the evening, like straight. They just had like an hour break or something like that. So I decided that that wasn't the type which was suitable for me. Like I couldn't sit there in a class like 12 hours straight or something like that. So then I decided to come back to Bangalore and then bought a PrepLadder subscription. That's where my preparation started. Then I used to dedicate myself, like I started off with like just 6 to 7 hours a day.
So guys, by this thing we can also understand that it depend on student to student, that whether he can study in Gautam Nagar, because you know every student can't able to sit for regularly for 12 hours or 10 hours. However, the coaching institute set the time that student have to study for 10 hour long or 12 hour long. So guys, that is a very important thing. Before we go for preparation anywhere, like Delhi, as the Dr. Avinash told, he flew from Bangalore to Delhi, and after coming to Delhi, he was not comfortable with the environment. He was not comfortable with the study pattern, because as he told that he can't able to sit for a long time. The condition is same with me, and I know that many students are there like me and like Dr. Avinash, that they can't regularly sit, because as we are sitting with many of the students, you know, there is a lot of crowd. The crowd is around of 100, 200 and maybe more. So that's not a comfortable place to study. That is a comfortable place for many students, but it doesn't depend for every student. It vary from every student to every student, as I told you before also. So guys, it depends fully on you that whether you like to study in the Gautam Nagar or you like to study anywhere else. And the best resource that we can use, that is a prep letter or Mero. Many subscription are there, many online resources are there for study. So as before also, I made I think 2-3 videos I told you about the prep letter, everything briefly I told you about prep letter. So guys, the same thing Dr. Avinash told, that he went to Delhi, but again he came back to the Bangalore and then he bought the subscription of the prep letter. So guys, this is the reason that I am telling you about the prep letter app and what are the important thing and what are the things I usually like, and more things I will explain you if you need to know about the prep letter also. So let's move to the next point. So Dr. Avinash, please let our viewers know that what was your strategy for the preparation of FMG exam, because as I think many of the students have a strategy and many don't have any kind of a strategy. So what was your strategy to prepare for FMG exam? So please let our viewers know.
I specifically didn't have a strategy or something like that. I just started off with prep letter subscription, and then I was to watch, like, I started off with major subjects. For the major subjects, I used main videos. Main videos, as in there are two types of videos on prep letter. The first one being the main videos, and the other one is the rapid revision course. Whereas the main videos are like detailedly explained once, and all the chapter and the concepts are detailedly explained. So I used the main videos for all the major subjects. And as days went by, I increased the study hours from 5 to 6, 6 to 7, something like that. It kept increasing. Then after that, every day make sure you have like 1 to 2 hours dedicated to solve those MCQs on what you have studied on that day. And then I just continued doing this, and once my major subjects were done, I started off with rapid revision for all those minor subjects. I think rapid revision is really good enough for the minor subjects. And then once I finished with this minor subjects as well, I used this rapid revision to again revise all my major subjects and my minor subjects as well.
So guys, as Dr. Avinash told us about the study pattern, first of all, he told us about the prep letter app, as he took the prep letter app, and he also told that the rapid revision, that is important. If you don't know about the major and the minor subject, then I will make a separate video about it, that what are the major subjects and what are the minor subjects. If you wanna study from the prep letter, then you can take the both type of pattern. Like if you wanna take rapid revision, then that is a different thing, because the rapid revision is important before the exam. Because like if you are having the exam in December and now you are preparing for your exam, so you can use the rapid revision. But if you have a lot of time, like you are in a third year, you are in a fourth year, also you are in a fifth year, then you can take the full prep letter app, which consists of every video. That is not a kind of rapid revision, but also have the option of the rapid revision. So by the help of that, what you can do, you can study the major subject from the main prep letter source, which are given, like lengthy videos are given that you can study. But rapid revision is a combination of everything. It consists of the image based question, like a snapshot. That consists of many of the image based question, like videos also it consists, and the rapid revision, which consists of all the videos. Like if a lecture is of around 26 hours, then it is minimized to 6 hours or 10 hours. So guys, that is the important thing what Dr. Avinash told us, that he used the rapid revision and also used the prep letter, the lengthy videos for the major subject. So guys, by this we can also get to know that how much prep letter is helpful, and how did he cleared his MCA exam by the help of the prep letter. So let's move to the next point, that Dr. Avinash, please suggest any important thing which students should remember before the exam, because as you know, many students are depressed, many students are stressed before the exam. So what is the actual thing we need to know before the exam? So please suggest anything.
A very important suggestion would be, make sure you have like 8 hours of sleep the night before you take the exam, because your exam would usually start off like 7 and then end in 5 p.m. I guess. So if you don't have a proper sleep, I'm sure you can't have those concentration on every question which you really really need, because as far as I have seen, this paper was really lengthy one, and so you need to make sure you have enough time and your brain is ready to take that challenge of reading that lengthy questions and then catching that one important line which gets you to the answer. So make sure you have a very sound sleep right before your exam, and then go to the exam with full confidence, and I'm sure everyone who has done all this would really crack it.
So guys, till now we get to know many things from the Dr. Avinash. So finally we want to complete this video and this is the end. So lastly, Dr. Avinash, I just want to know that please let our viewers know who are going to give the FMG exam in the future. What are the important key things that they should know before the exam? So please guide them for their future exam.
So my key suggestion for this exam particularly would be revision, because just imagine yourself, you kept studying every day for like 5 to 6 months with no breaks, and then the amount of information which is added into your brain should be recalled. Because if the information what you have put in your brain isn't recalled on the exam day, so whatever you have done, the hard work you have put for this 5 to 6 months would be really a waste. So make sure you have this 1 month or 1.5 month as for your convenience allotted only for revision and solving MCQs. Doesn't matter how much you have finished in these 4 to 5 months of your preparation, make sure you stop at the certain point and then start revising. That would be my suggestion. And then also there are a few Telegram groups which keep posting MCQs on daily basis, so make sure you attend those quizzes, which will really help you also. And there are certain doctors who keep teaching us for free on certain platforms like YouTube and then an academy. Dr. Ashish, Dr. Preeti Sharma, Dr. Sushant Soni, Dr. Azam, and these people keep teaching us, like they have certain revision videos just posted before the exam, which even I went through before my exams, which really helped me. Especially Dr. Ashish sir and Dr. Preeti Sharma's videos really helped me a lot. So I would also suggest you guys to follow them.
So thank you, Dr. Avinash, for giving your precious time to us. And thanks a lot to our viewers also for watching this video. So if you like this video, so make sure to subscribe our channel and also to share the video. So thank you guys. Milte ko naye video mein ek naye topic ke sath. Tab tak ke liye bye bye. Khuda hafiz. Dasif Daniya.